Thinking aloud. Conversations on the leading edge of knowledge and discovery with psychologist Jeffrey Mishlove.
Serios was a Chicago bellhop.
Correct.
He was researched primarily, as I recall, in the 1960s, 1970s, and mostly by a Denver psychiatrist, Dr. Jule Eisenbud.
Right. Serios had been experimenting with hypnosis, and he discovered while he was playing with hypnosis that he could make images appear on film, first on regular box cameras, and then on the newly invented Polaroid system of so-called instant photography. Mm-hmm. And that's one of the reasons the case is important, because Serios's images were produced on the spot, and there could be no question that darkroom techniques were involved in the production of the photos. And Eisenbud mm-hmm. conducted his research between 1964 and 1967, and that's when most of the good phenomena took place.
And I understand Serios, his abilities declined over time.
They ended pretty abruptly in June of 1967 when he produced an anomalous picture of curtains. And Eisenbud, uh-huh. being the psychiatrist, saw the symbolism immediately. Uh-huh. Fini, the curtains had come down on the most productive phase of Serios's career.
But he continued to produce anomalous photographs. In fact, you worked with him many years later, as I recall.
Yes, that's true. The kinds of anomalous photographs that Serios produced at that time and had produced earlier were called blackies and whiteies. These are important because the blackies look like they were entirely or mostly underexposed. They were just black pictures. Mm-hmm. And the reason those were anomalous is that light had not been prevented from reaching the Polaroid lens. Mm-hmm. Whiteys were just the opposite. They looked like they were severely overexposed, but they occurred under conditions in which all light had been presumably prevented from reaching the film.
But the most interesting pictures are not blackies or whiteys. They're very detailed images.
Well, let's not demean the blackies and whiteys, yeah. because one of the reasons they're important mm-hmm. is that it has to do with the way in which skeptics try to explain away Serios's productions altogether.
Yes.
And you're right that Serios also produced various kinds of anomalous images, sometimes ostensibly corresponding to target pictures which had been placed in opaque envelopes and Serios mm-hmm. had never seen.
Yeah.
Sometimes they were just spontaneous productions of Serios.
But we should say Eisenbud worked with him extensively. Many, many dozens of people witnessed the phenomena.
Quite true, including several conjurers.
Mm-hmm.
So the controls were, I think, very, very solid. And all the people who witnessed the photographs would sign off on the back, indicating that this exactly was the photograph that had been produced and so mm-hmm. on. So Eisenbud has sworn affidavits from the various people who participated.
Mm-hmm. And he employed the most rigorous methodologies he was able to bring to bear.
Yes, I mean, he would use marked packs of film, marked cameras. Serios would sometimes not even touch the camera. Sometimes Serios was at a distance from the camera when the photographs were produced. Sometimes he was placed in an electrically shielded Faraday cage, separated from the camera, which was on the outside of the cage.
Mm-hmm.
Those were among the controls imposed.